What a nice boat to take a load off in, eh, Polly?
Polly agrees. This is the life.
What do you say we hit a few dockside bars with this baby, huh?
I'm down.
What is happening, guys? I got a Barbie boat here that I got from the swap meet for $6. I'm gonna try to transform it into a G.I. Joe boat, more specifically Shipwreck's boat. I wanna make sure that, you know, Shipwreck has something that really matches his character. Haven't really decided on the colors yet, but right now my challenge is taking it apart. I don't think this was necessarily assembled with screws. Obviously this thing's gonna be in the water, so I'd imagine that maybe Barbie didn't want screws, you know, getting rusty when kids are playing with the boat. I've already tried to pry it open, as you can see, and I chipped the side off here. Big mistake. Prying it apart isn't gonna work. So I guess my challenge here is taping off the boat in some areas, painting it, taking the tape off, and then painting that area that I taped. So I don't know how it's gonna come out. I'm gonna start taping off the parts that I don't wanna paint first, and we'll go from there. All right, guys, another update. So I went ahead and taped off pretty much everywhere that I don't want paint on right now. I'm gonna try to make these seats a tan color, which most likely is gonna also be the floors, because I feel like it's gonna be very complicated to separate the black and the brown, but I'm gonna give it a shot. I want a nice brown interior, like that brown leather look. I spray painted the entire interior brown, and the color that you see matching here is the same color as the seats. I totally forgot to record the seats before I taped it up, but they're looking good. They're brown, so I'm stoked to show you guys how it looks in the next clip, but I have everything taped off on the bottom here, so it's time to paint the top. I think I'm gonna go with midnight blue. Oh yeah, she already looking nice. All right, guys, it's the next morning after letting this dry overnight. I went ahead and sprayed the inside. You got the floor, the steering wheel, matte black. I still have the seats covered, so I'm gonna go ahead and peel them off right now, see what I missed. If there's anything that I missed that may be pink still or blue, I'm just gonna have to go over it with a brush and acrylic paint. I'm gonna start peeling off the windshield, the dashboard, and the seats. Once all that's peeled off, we're gonna move to the bottom and start painting the base black. Went ahead and covered it all in black. Man, it looks really nice with a glossy black, but I had to go with the flat here, so it's not gonna look shiny like this after it's dried, but let's just admire it before it does dry up. Bottom has been painted black. I'm gonna go ahead and peel off this tape. All right, guys, I filled in some details. The seats, I think, came out great. I know there's a little bit of pink popping out there, but I'm gonna, you know, brush that up with some midnight blue too. This right here I painted black so I can create some sort of gun pit in there. Attach some sort of rifle or something right there to make it look like a weaponized speedboat. Let's see, what else? Oh, the dashboard. I got my acrylic paint marker here, very thin point, and just filled in all the details on the dashboard. Just an extra touch, you know, bring it to life more. Now, the only thing that's really bothering me, guys, it's a real eyesore, is this damn windshield. I hate how the yellow comes in. There's no way I'm gonna get this window out and be able to paint it by itself. Probably gonna have to hand paint it with acrylic paint. I'm thinking if I could do sort of like a cartoon type of window where this would be all like a very light baby blue, and then in the windows I can make like white, what do you call it, glare lines, how you see on like shining windows.
Check it out, guys. I painted the entire window with acrylic paint, went with a nice soft baby blue. Still finishing up on the inside there, but I think this looks way better than the yellow. I just couldn't take the yellow being with the blue and the black. Just looks weird to me. If you'll notice, I drew a box right here. I traced the line of the frame with my black acrylic marker. And what I'm gonna do is do the rest with the other frames. That way I have an outline, and I'm gonna go ahead and paint the outer frames black. So that way all you'll see is just the windows blue, so it'll make them pop more. Once I do that, then I'll start adding in the details like the shining streaks on the window themselves with like a white brush. So far so good. I like this way better than the yellow. What do you think? All right, check it out, guys. See, I got some masking tape sort of shaping the lines for me. They're guiding me so I can get a nice straight line for those. So I got one there, one thick one there, and then another slim one there. So just waiting for the top coat to dry, and then I'll add another one and strip these off. Well, guys, I almost had the perfect streaks, and then it went to shit. I guess one of the windows weren't fully dried yet with the blue paint, so it attached itself to the masking tape and ripped off. Clean off the window, so. All right, folks, she's just about done. I repainted the window and decided not to go with that streak because I'm not trying to do that all over again, just in case it rips off again. But I really dig the seats, man. That nice brown, nice interior, the dash, inside painted blue. I think she came out good. All right, guys, so what do you think? The finished product here, Shipwreck and his very own speedboat. Just very quick, very easy, very cheap. Like I said, $6 at the swap meet. You cannot beat that, guys. When it comes to 1/12 scale vehicles, you can always count on the flea markets, swap meets, to have a ton of stuff such as Barbie cars, Bratz cars. You know, there's a lot more stuff coming out, you know, like the Fortnite boat. I really wish I would have done that one, but everyone's doing that one right now. The only one that I could get my hands on was this Barbie boat, so Shipwreck fits perfectly inside. And this is supposed to be a boat for Barbies, guys. So the Barbies, they like, I feel like when Barbies are in their vehicles, they unnaturally stick out. Like literally their heads will be where my fingers are and their legs will go all the way into the bottom here. Like they're too big for their vehicle. Polly fits perfectly on the windshield. The legs on Polly like perfectly clip on the edge there, as you can see. You get you a closer look at the interior. As you can see, it just looks good, man. I'm proud the way this came out. I still haven't gotten the chance to add some type of rifle or a weapon on this end. I feel like that's gonna take a little bit more creativity. I don't know. Shoot me some ideas in the comments of what you guys would do with that little extra space in the front. But this boat, as you can see, you could do a lot of cool stuff with it, man. I got some pretty sweet shots of Polly and Shipwreck chilling out in the ocean, watching the sunset. By the way, if you guys are wondering how the heck I did that, that was obviously a 4K TV in the background, boat set up in the very center of it, and just getting the right zoom action, and it just looks like it's the actual background. But, yeah, man, there you have it. Let me know what you guys think. I missed a couple spots there, but that's not going to be displayed that way. That's always going to be flipped down. In the future, I can't wait to actually put this boat in one of my movies involving Shipwreck and, Torpedo. Maybe Torpedo takes a deep dive down, jumps off the speedboat, does some sort of underwater operation while Shipwreck waits above. Something like that, man. I got some cool stuff planned for the future. But anyway, I just wanted to show you guys my quick idea of this boat. Comment below what you think. Let me know if you guys would like to see more of these 1/12 scale vehicle customizations, because it's something that I really love to do on the side. I love painting stuff. I love going to the flea market and just finding some random pieces and just thinking what I could do with those pieces and bringing those ideas to life. It's a really fun hobby to do on the side, and in the end, it just makes my G.I. Joe collection look 10 times sweeter. I hope you enjoyed this quick video. I hope you enjoy your figs, your families, and as always, good hunting. Peace!